subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello friends, welcome back to weekly update session on current banking and financial awareness. Friends, here these banking updates I am covering between 26 January to 31st July, which will be useful for your all upcoming banking exams. Friends, and you can also download this lecture PDF from our Telegram channel. The Telegram channel link I have given in description section, and also I have pinned in comment box. That is the first comment. It is our Telegram channel link. Friends, now we'll start our session, and don't forget to watch full video. It will be useful for your all upcoming examinations. So don't skip any question. Now we'll move forward. Now the question says, the Reserve Bank of India has approved to the Government of Union Territory of Ladakh to acquire dash percentage stake in Jammu and Kashmir Bank Limited. RBI has approved to the Government of Union Territory, that is Ladakh, to acquire dash percentage of stake in Jammu and Kashmir Bank Limited. Now we'll see the options first. The options are A 8.32%, B 8.05%, C 8.23%, D 8.5%, in and of this. Friends, recently Reserve Bank of India has approved to Government of UT of Ladakh to acquire an 8.23. It is option C, here right answer, 8.23% stake in Jammu and Kashmir Bank Limited. So as a date of enforcement of this Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019. So this act also, here also you have to remember, that is Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act. The act was made in 2019, 31st October 2019, this act came into force. So as per this act, this Reserve Bank of India has approved to Government of UT of this Ladakh to acquire 8.23% stake in Jammu and Kashmir Bank Limited. So this 8.23% stake in this bank has acquired by our Government of UT, it is Ladakh. Now moving on to next question. The question says, SVAS, SVAS Wellness, it is a wholly owned subsidiary of Dr. Reddy's Laboratories. It has partnered with which general insurance company to offer cashless outpatient services? Now we'll see the options first. Options are A, Kotak Mahindra General Insurance Company Limited, B, ACO General Insurance Limited, C, ICICI Lombard General Insurance Company, D, HDFC ERCO General Insurance Co. Limited. In and of this. Friends, here the right answer is option C, it is ICICI Lombard General Insurance Company. Friends, this was, it is a, already I told, it is subsidiary of Dr. Reddy's Laboratories. So it has partnered with this ICICI Lombard General Insurance Company to offer cashless outpatient services. So due to this partnership, this general insurance company, the ICICI, will be able to perform and demonstrate their contribution to this wellness sector. So they have entered, these two have entered into partnership to offer cashless outpatient service. To health insurance policy holders in India. So option C, finally it is ICICI Lombard is the right answer for this question. So Dr. Reddy's subsidiary company, that is SVAS, and this ICICI Lombard. Now coming to next question, the question says, Reserve Bank of India has increased the limit of loan that can be sanctioned by banks to director of associates of the other banks without board approval. So the hindrance limit is, friends, RBI recently increased the limit of loan to whom that directors are associates of other banks. So without board approval, that new limit they have increased. So that board approval is not needed. So here asking, so that what is the new enhanced limit? It is an enhanced limit. We'll see the options. Options are A, 5 crore, B, 4 crore, C, 3 crore, D, 2 crore, in and of this. Friends, recently Reserve Bank of India has raised the limit of loans so that can be sanctioned by a bank to any director or associates of other banks. So without their board approval, so they can sanction loan maximum 5 crore. So option A is the right answer in this question. So maximum 5 crore they can sanction a loan. So earlier this limit was only 25 lakh. So this also you remember. Earlier this limit was 25 lakh only. For example, if any bank wants to sanction a loan to other bank directors, so they can sanction loan up to maximum 25 lakh in earlier. But recently, so RBI has increased this limit 25 lakh to 5 crore. It is 5 crore. So option A, it is right answer for this question. Now moving on to next question. The question says, Alphabet, the parent company of Google, of course. So it has announced to launch a new company named Dash, which will be focused on software development for robots. So Google, Alphabet, and one more company they named. So they are asking that company name. I'll repeat question once again. So Alphabet, it is a parent company of Google. So it has announced to launch a new company. For what? For which purpose they are launching this new company? For software development on robots. Now, which is the options first? Options are A. Aerotech Corp. B. Fanuc. C. Intrinsic. D. Rockwell. In one of these. Friends, the parent company of Google named Alphabet has announced they launch a new company. So that name is Intrinsic. It is option C. It is Intrinsic. So which will be focused mainly on software development for robots. So for this intrinsic company, new CEO name his name is Wendy Tan White. So just you remember White. So you will get confused by reading these names. So just remember White. Actually full name is Wendy Tan White. So he is the new CEO of intrinsic. Definitely in upcoming generation, this question may ask who is the new CEO for this interesting company. So like that they will ask question. So that time you remember his name is White, like that Wendy Tan White. Now it may ask headquarters also. So the headquarters of this interesting company, it is also California. Now like this Alphabet also California, no? So this headquarters also it is California. Now moving on to next question. The question says, Apple allows new payment modes for its users in India along with App Store and iTunes. So what are they? So Apple already allowing new payment modes in their mobile, that is App Store and iTunes. So along with this there are how many new payment modes are there allowing? No, which is option? Options are A. UPI, B. Net Banking, C. Rupee, D. ABC, A and B and C. Means UPI, Net Banking, Rupee in and of this. Friends, recently RBI has introduced three new payment modes for its users in India. So App Store and iTunes for users in India now include along with this UPI, Net Banking, Rupee. So option D, right answer, means A, B, C. So as so this development indicated that Apple users will now be able to make payments using this major India payment system. So like this UPI, Net Banking, Rupee. And besides this, the balance can be used for to pay for streaming services, namely like Netflix, Amazon Prime, and Apple One services like Apple Arcade and Apple One. So it is launched in 2012. Rupee card facilities, real time electronic payments at all banks and financial institutions in India. So then this UPI was launched in the year 2016. This Rupee launched in 2012. So this due to this payment service, so this Apple also supporting this Made in India digital platforms. So in that concept, Apple has introduced the three main payment method in their Apple Store, that is UPI, Net Banking, and Rupee. Now moving on to next question. The question says, Magma Fincorp Limited, so RBI re-registered this NBFC as, so they renamed this NBFC name as, so earlier this Magma Fincor Limited, now they re-registered and with the new name. So they are asking that new name. We'll see the options. Options are a Fino Ecor India Limited, B New Magma Fincorp Private Limited, C Pune Wala Fincorp Limited, D Sigma E Fincorp Limited, in none of this. Friends, this Magma Fincorp Limited, so RBI registered unbanking finance company and NBFC, they have been renamed as Poonawalla Fincorp Limited. So option C, it is right answer for this question. So Poonawalla Fincorp Limited, so it has also initiated a rebranding their activity, that is the acquisition of this controlling stake by other Poonawalla, and he is led raising the Sun Holdings Private Limited. So along with this, it is fully owned housing finance subsidiary of this Magma Housing Finance Company Limited, and it also renamed as Poonawalla Housing Finance Limited. Friends, when it comes to chairman of this Poonawalla Fincorp Limited, that is Magma Fincorp Limited, his name is Adar Poonawalla. He is the present chairman of this Poonawalla Fincorp Limited. So you need to remember, Magma, earlier its name is Magma Fincorp Limited. Now they are re-registered with RBA as Poonawalla Fincorp Limited. Now next question. Name the new service has launched by SWIFT, Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. That abbreviation is SWIFT. So it is a global provider of the secure financial messaging services. So this SWIFT, that new service launched, so that enables small business and consumers. So what is that new service? So the question is simply, SWIFT has launched new service. So that service, for one purpose, that enables small businesses and consumers. So this service is useful for small businesses and consumers. So they are asking that service name. Which is the options? Options are A. Go SWIFT, B. SWIFT Go, C. Quick SWIFT, D. Easy SWIFT. In none of this. Friends, this SWIFT, Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication, so this SWIFT, so it is, as I told, it is a global provider of the secure financial messaging services. So it has launched this SWIFT Go. SWIFT Go, option B, it right answer. SWIFT Go, it is a transformative new service, and also it enables small businesses and consumers to send fast, predictable, high secure and competitively priced low value cross-border payments anywhere in the world, that to direct from their bank accounts. So around 7 global banks, so which collectively handle this 33 million low value cross-border payments, so per year. So it has already live with services. So this SWIFT Go, it is enables financial institutions, so to offer a seamless payments experience for low value transactions often initiated by small and medium sized enterprise, that is SMEs. So to pay suppliers overseas and by consumers sending money to friends as well as family internationally. So that simply I can say this SWIFT Go, for what purpose? This SWIFT Go, it is a new service, so it is enables for small businesses and consumers to send fast and predictable, high secure and competitively priced low value cross-border payments to anywhere in the world. So they can transfer anywhere in the world with this SWIFT Go. So you need to remember SWIFT Go, it is a new service launched by SWIFT for enabling small businesses and consumers to very competitive low price and high secure also. They can send money and cross-border transactions with anywhere in India. Anywhere is not anywhere in India, it is anywhere in the world. And when it comes to SWIFT chief product officer name is, his name is Stephen Gildrell. You need to remember Stephen Gildrell, he is a new, he is a CPO, that is chief product officer of SWIFT. Remember and abbreviation of this SWIFT, it is must ensure. Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. Now moving on to next question. The question says, under the co-lending agreement was signed between with which bank and Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited, Indiabulls HFL, to offer home loans to home buyers at a competitive interest rate. So simply, Indiabulls HFL, Indiabulls Finance Company Limited, has signed an agreement with which bank to offer home loans to home buyers at competitive interest rates. Now we'll see the options. First options are A. Axis Bank, B. Bank of Baroda, C. ICICI Bank, D. Yes Bank. In any of this, friends, this co-lending agreement, this agreement was signed between Yes Bank and Indiabulls. So option D, trade answer, Yes Bank and Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited to offer home loans to home buyers at competitive rates. So both these entities will jointly work to offer a seamless experience to retail home loan customers for their banks. So here they have to so they decided to give very competitive price housing. So who are eagerly buying for home loans, no? So can buy and purchase for houses, so they can contact with this S Bank and Indiabulls Limited. So they both made an agreement, it is co-lending agreement, so that to offer very competitive prices home loan interest rates. In terms of starting part of this question, the Indiabulls S Bank's both headquarters, it is Mumbai only, and tagline of S Bank, it is experience or expertise. And now when it comes to heads of these companies, that is Yes Bank MD and CEO, his name is Prashant Kumar, and as well as Indiabulls MD, his name is Gagan Banga. Gagan Banga is Indiabulls MD and Yes Bank MD name is Prashant Kumar. These two you remember. Now moving on to next question. Now next question says, the Reserve Bank of India has cancelled license of which Urban Cooperative Bank Limited? Now we'll see the options. Options are A. Mapusa Urban Cooperative Bank of Goa Limited, B. the Goa State Cooperative Bank Limited, C. the SVC Urban Cooperative Bank, D. Madgaon Urban Cooperative Bank Limited. In none of this. Friends, recently RBI has cancelled license of this Goa based Urban Cooperative Bank. So that cooperative bank name is, it is Madgaon Urban Cooperative Bank Limited. Recently RBI cancelled license of this Madgaon Cooperative Bank Limited. So its headquarters, it is Madgaon, Goa. So the license was cancelled because the bank's financial position was not able to pay its present depositor. So this was the main reason behind this cancellation of this license. So this Madgaon Urban Cooperative Bank Limited does not have adequate capital also. And that also, and earning prospects also not really good. So that's why RBI has decided to cancel this license of this cooperative bank. So you remember that cooperative bank name, Goa based cooperative bank name is, it is Madgaon Urban Cooperative Bank. So this is came into news recently. So you need to remember. Now when company start to come, of course RBI governor Shakti Kamdas. And moving on to the next question, the question says, who had permitted infrastructure finance company at IDFC to exit IDFC First Bank? So who had permitted infrastructure finance company IDFC? So IDFC, it is infrastructure finance company. So this, now it is exiting from IDFC First Bank. So who has given permission? Now it's in options. Options are A. Government of India, B. RBI, C. Finance Secretary, D. NHB, in and of this. Friends, of course it is RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Friends, the Reserve Bank of India had permitted this infrastructure finance company, that is IDFC, to exit this IDFC First Bank. So RBI had earlier said that this after the expiry of lock-in period for 5 years, this IDFC can exit as the promoter of this IDFC First Bank. So in this IDFC First Bank, IDFC, it is infrastructure company, so it is a promoter of this in this IDFC First Bank, no? So this IDFC had received a license to set up a full service bank in 2013. So, and that infrastructure lending business was carved into IDFC Bank. So now which began operations in 2015. So now IDFC hold stake in the bank that through a fully owned non-operative finance holdings, no? So this now the whole stake in IDFC Bank, it is in 36.6%. So a reverse merge would entail this an exit from this holding company. So now IDFC First Bank has now become the retail lender. Now this IDFC was exited from this IDFC First Bank now. So now IDFC First Bank has now become a retail lender, and it's moved away from the infrastructure heavy book, so they moved from this infrastructure loans. So that now this bank in 2018 merged with this IDFC and this Capital First now. So now the RBI has permitted this IDFC to exit this IDFC First Bank. That you need to remember in exam point of view. So they won't ask deep in this question our promoters and percentage, and they won't ask. But you remember that the whole stake in this IDFC First Bank, it is 36.6%. So this is stake had this IDFC. Now this IDFC is exiting from this IDFC First Bank. And if you haven't yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe my Invoting YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest notification to your mobile. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Jai Hind.